So, good morning, everyone. It's good to see many people here today for this fifth edition of the MIST Summit. First of all, bit of logistics. So we will have a lunch break with sandwiches here. During the summit, don't hesitate to jump into discussions, have questions, idea and so on. It's meant to be interactive, so don't hesitate to do it. It's something that we are really, welcoming, and our community is really, I would say, open and lax on the organization and so on. So don't hesitate. We are there for helping. So usually what we do during each summit after this year of activities and so on, we try to make a kind of quick summary. So we could pass one full day of all the activities we did for the past year. Obviously, for the whole team, the year was a bit crazy. I think maybe next year will be again crazy, but that's good news for everyone. Even for us, it's always super exciting to work with everyone. So I will quickly go through all the thing that we did in 2019, but it's really an overview on the key points, so that you can keep an eye on what's going on in MISP. So we had, for the past 2 years, we had a funding from the European Commission from a grant called the Connect Europe Facility, which is a CEF grant. And this one really boosted us a lot. So we were able basically to really extend MISP to a system that is used by a lot of technical people and so on, but to extend it to something that really used for information sharing communities and so on. So we really expanded during this past year at a really faster rate. So one of the techniques that we used to improve was really to, I would say, abuse and really use a workshop that we were doing. So I think everyone from the team did workshop trainings at various places in Europe and abroad. And for us, it was a quick way to collect information about what people want, what people really do on a day-to-day basis with MISP, bugs that they reported, features they want, and so on. And for us, it was really, really, a cool way of gathering feedback and so on. So we were able to basically extend a lot of MISP based on this feedback and to really want to continue on that. So for everyone here that want to organize trainings, either in Europe or abroad, just tell us and we can find agreements and so on for doing those trainings. On top of that, we discovered that, and that's, I think, a good sign for the community at large. It's a lot of standards are existing, and they will, as we always say, that there is no one standard to rule them all. So what we try to basically include in the project is as many standards that people are using to basically fit specific use cases and so on. So just as an example, one of our team members did a lot of work and involvement in Sticks 2. We did a lot of collaboration with Oasis 2 for improvement for the next release and so on. It's a bit slow compared to our model of development, but we were able to basically integrate a lot of things in MISP to support the various things. If you are using in some way, or tools are using some stick standards and import-export is causing issue in MISP and so on, reach out to us, send us sample, because sometimes you have to basically look at all those custom objects and so on to meet the requirement on that. Another thing that we are really happy with is basically Maitre Attack. They did a lot of involvement in the past years, and they have some really crazy idea to get feedback. So Friday this week, maybe some of you will join us. We have this Attack EU community, which we do usually during ACLU, and it's really a community of people using Attack. And what we have seen nowadays is obviously, and that's great, a lot of organizations are using it. But on top of that, Maitre has very good idea in the future to gather automatically the feedback on the techniques used and so on. One of those is the sightings. So we recently introduced the Attack sightings into MISP. It's the first iterations. More things will come. But that's something that we really want to do because it's helping everyone to basically extend techniques and so on. I will talk quickly afterwards of some extension we did in MISP to support matrix that looks like the Attack one for other functionalities and other models. And we have already 5 of those. But if you come with other models, just let us know and we can incorporate those. So we are not bound to one specific models, but we are really supporting those one. Same, for open source tools or an open standard that are basically on a day-to-day basis creating their standards, we try to basically combine with ours. A lot of things that we do in MIST is basically embedding existing one like Sigma and so on to basically benefit from those very customized formats that are really working very well. Thing that we have seen too is a lot of ISAC and sharing communities are popping up in Europe, mainly using MISP, and that's a great move. So what we did on the past year, it's basically supporting those communities to set up sharing communities, how they work, not only the data model or the technical aspects, but even the way of promoting the sharing information and so on. So that's something that is really important for us. If you are running a sharing community, an existing one or a new one, and you want some support from us, let us know and we can collaborate. We did that with various one in Europe, and even abroad. And it was quite successful because usually it's kind of interaction that we had on the creation of content, for example. I will go back to the trainings aspect too, because we provide content for the trainings and some of the ISAC, for example, did translation of those trainings too. Another thing that we did, and for this one is the first step for us. The format that we are using in MISP start to be very used by a lot of other open source tools and even proprietary tools. And to clarify the separations and the clear separation between the open source software and the format and the standard, we spin off an initiative called MISP-standard.org, which is basically the structures that will host all the standards that we are building. So we have this model and we plan to keep that model where we basically implement something and then if it's successful, we are doing a standard out of it. So this one is the first step. More will come around that. The idea behind is really to have a website where we publish all the specification documents. For example, we have some plan regarding the research API that this one could be standardized to open to other standards. And for example, we have some talks today of people that are basically extending MISP or have idea of extending MISP with other tool set, but they want to be compatible with the API. So that's a thing that we are going in that direction too. If you're interested in regarding the creation of ISAC, so the Cross ISAC initiative is a spin-off of our project too, where we have a publications on how to set up your own sharing communities. So it might be interesting for you if you build a new community to have a look at those documents. Again, everything is open source, people can contribute back and so on. So to go more a bit deep into the outcome in 2019, we just did some statistics, so like that you see how the project is evolving over time. What you can see is the number of issues. So you have basically the issue on the left side from the core project, the object contribution and the Galaxy libraries. So obviously we see a steady rate of things going on. So again, statistics, you can say anything you want about statistics, but basically what you can see here is we have a lot of issues. Some are open. If you want to contribute on specific issues like helping people installing SSL certificates, having issue with their CentOS installation and so on, feel free to help us there because you see the gap is a bit increasing on the open one. So that's something that might help us too. Thing that we have seen is there's really a trend of collaboration on various things. The thread actor database that we are maintaining for the galaxies is now used by a lot of other tools. A lot of contributions are coming from third parties. And we see that it's a regular contribution. So when we started, we were basically like having barely no contributions. And nowadays it's basically half of the galaxy are basically maintained by third parties that are supporting us. So that's one thing. So we have seen that in 2019, we had a major upgrade there and major issue that we had to solve. But that's great because it means that we are attracting a larger group of new user contributors. Obviously, it's bringing new challenges, especially on the aspect of the different use cases. You have people that are using MISP for pure analysis with a small data set, and you have people that are really using MISP for large data sets and doing quick lookup and so on, which are sometimes different use cases. So we try to evolve the software to meet those requirements in the future. But that's why sometimes you have people that really want some features that basically are not so important for some other users. So thing that is interesting too, security vulnerabilities. We are quite open on that, and that's something that we really want to push there, because part of the team is basically working in a CSIRT, so we have to deal with security vulnerabilities. So in 2019, we had 9 CVE assigned to the MISCORE software. So for us, it's super important that people are first reporting vulnerabilities. If they find thing that might be a security issue and they have a doubt, don't hesitate to reach out. It's important for us. It's really something that we really want to push forward. We don't mind to have a lot of CVE. So that's to be clear. For us, it means that the project is active, running, and we have a lot of users that are basically reviewing the code. By the way, thanks to all the reporters, we had some great reporters that even provide the patch directly to the code, which is, I think, an advantage that we can get in the security community that we are in. We have software engineers that are finding bugs, security vulnerabilities, and fixing it immediately, which is great. So everything is documented on the security webpage. So now we maintain a completely zero CVEs, and we have a fast track for assigning CVE for MISP. So other outcomes. Thing that were started as basically, I would say, experimental project came to become more stable nowadays. So, for example, the dashboard is now more and more used by users. And then there is a new release foreseen in the next weeks where there is a better integrations with the authentication against MISP. So like that, you can easily bundle the dashboard with a MISP together and basically rely on the authentication mechanism in MISP in the dashboard directly. Another big step, so we have now implemented in MISP the decaying model for indicators. So Sami will present today the complete implementations, which is interesting because it was like a very long-standing project. So in 2018, we did multiple academic papers. We experimented many things. So this one is basically the implementations that can be used directly in MISP. So I think it's one of the first software that is basically having such kind of models. So we can even share the models of decayings. So right now we have by default 2 decaying models, but you can extend those ones. So we are expecting that in the future we will get the same stuff than the taxonomies and the galaxy, that more people will contribute their own models, so like that we can get those different models for the different use case directly. Another thing that we released last year in December was basically all the training that we had are released as open source and open content. So all the slides, LaTeX slides, materials and so on are now completely open source. You have around 36 hours of trainings. So you have materials for doing a lot of trainings. Not only the MISP software itself, but you have additional training for the OSINT part. So we have some practical training on how to do OSINT. So you are using MISP, but other tools to basically work as an analyst and so on. We have a specific slide deck and a specific content that is basically an extraction from the cross-ISAC document that we did for the ISACs, where we basically explain how to build sharing communities. So it's all the pitfalls, all the issues we had when running our own communities, and we explain all of those into that document. So what we really are looking for, it's basically people contributing first to fix our broken English, that would be cool, to fix additional things like, for example, the OSINT analysis, to extend it to multiple things or additional use case. And if you have feedback on the building sharing communities, to add your own experience on building those sharing communities. Another thing that's interesting too is translations. I don't know if Kuhn is in the room. Yes, he's there. So thanks to him, he did a contribution for some of the slides in for Dutch translations, but we are really looking for additional translations. There is an ongoing one for Spanish, because the South American CSIRT are using MISP, and they did a full translation of the slide decks. But if you have some time to do translations on those slide decks, it will be interesting. So it's super easy to do it. It's a GitHub repository. You just spin off subdirectories with the subfiles with translations, and you can basically do it. So then if you look at more at the core, what has been done, a lot of rework has been done on the research, and this one is a, I would say, major change, and that's something that will be, I think, for the long or the next years will be very stable, and we really want to capitalize on that one, is to improve the research API, especially to make it unify across all export and so on. It's already the case, but you have plenty of rework there that will be done in the futures. Another thing that a lot of work has been done on the export system, so you can basically now use the same research queries for exporting in different formats. There's a REST client now with a graphical user interface where you can basically play with it. We have different templating aspects and so on. Another thing that we did, and this one is an interesting model, during one of the attack community workshops, someone came with a different model that MyTrade doesn't plan to implement, but it was very interesting too for specific use cases. It was for the financial sectors. And what we decided to do is maybe we should support in MISP the import of existing matrix-like data structures directly into MISP, just like we do for attack. And nowadays, by default, we have like 4 or 5 matrix-like galaxies. So it's brand new, but it's really an easy way to extend matrix-like dataset into MISP. A lot of update has been done on the graphing features, especially the graph, the event graph view, where you can basically now modelize easily the graph relationship between your different objects in an event. There's plenty of work on the object aspect too. Something that has been, I think, very extended nowadays is the MISP modules support, where you basically have now the support of object too. So that means the MISP modules, if you export an object, you can basically get back into MISP. Another thing that we worked on is the setup of multiple MISP. That's something that we had as a setup at work, but a lot of our users have the same kind of setup nowadays, which is very useful for having distributed data models at different places, especially that sometimes you don't want to have everything in a single MISP for performance reason, ACL reason, or even segregations of duty and so on. So now we have this ability to cache MISP instances. So that means within an organization, you can basically pull data just as caching without importing the full data set into your MISP. And then a lot of things have been improved on the CLI management. We were participating to the Lockshield challenge in NATO, and then we discovered that deploying 50 MISP at the same time was not really the most easy part to do. So that's why we worked on the CLI management, that you can do a lot of things directly from that. We have even a nice script for training there. So if you want to set up your own MISP for trainings, you can basically use that one for creating users and stuff like that. And obviously the decaying models, we will go into detail in that one, but this one was a long-standing thing that we really wanted, because a lot of people have indicators and attributes that they want to decay at some point. But this model is quite clever, because we don't want to force people to have a specific decaying models or to have a models in MISP that is forcing to remove data. It's a model that is basically just an overlay on top of your existing data set to apply a decaying model. So basically expiring indicators and stuff like that. So another thing that is interesting too is we basically nearly double our object template. So the object template are basically describing new data structures in MISP. We starting in last year in around 90 object templates, and now we are close to 150 object templates, and mainly those templates are coming from external contributions. So it's super easy to create your own object template. So if you have a data model, thing that you want to create and so on, you can just create an object template, share it with the others, or keep it for yourself. So you can do both. What we have seen is a lot of, I would say, dynamic work there on the telecom sector. So a lot of objects were created by the telecom sector. For example, SS7, GTP, diameters, IMSI catcher output too. So that's basically output that you can reuse for telecom. We had an interesting meeting last week with an European project that is working on the telecom sector. And we have some new models and new objects that will be added soon. Obviously, cybersecurity, you have tons of new objects ranging from specific sandbox reporting models and others, but it's coming from various models too. Thing that we have seen is a trend of more, I would say, traditional security models. So, for example, we have nowadays vehicles models, we have one for Interpol notice and stuff like that are not used by us as CSIRT, but that are used by other organizations. So you can really customize your MISP with your own object models to basically transport any data that you like. Another thing that we have seen is a trend. In 2018, basically, one force was really the composition of object over the attributes, but nowadays we see the trend reversing, so we have more objects than single attributes. So which is a good sign, because that means people are putting more context on the information and so on, and just not putting single indicators in events in MIST, but really more advanced data structures with object and relationship, describing more complex model and so on. So same with the taxonomy. So nowadays we have 102 taxonomies, so I will not go through all of those, and they are regularly updated and so on. Maybe one interesting one that just popped up recently, this one is coming from the work of First.org. It was from a special interest group, which did work on the industrial control system. And they basically did a lot of effort of mapping, I think it's called ISA standard, which is a standard for classifying industrial control systems. So now we have a complete set of taxonomies there for industrial control system. Maybe something that I heard that many times about people think, oh, it's a lot of taxonomy, so that means in MISP you can use everything you like. The reality being is different. The taxonomy there are as libraries, and then it's up to your organizations and your group to sub-select what you really want. So there are some, for example, we know some groups that are just using two taxonomies, and that's fine. So the taxonomies there are not to expand the number of things, but it's just to represent the world. So it's like you have in the world different languages, you cherry pick the languages that you talk in your sharing communities, but you don't use all the languages in your sharing community. So it's really important for us that those taxonomies are just a subset for your day-to-day work. So if you see things that are missing and so on, just don't hesitate to update existing one or to contribute new ones if needed. So same with Galaxy. So we have now around 40 galaxies. So for example, Maitreya Attack is part of the Galaxies models, or Trade Actor Database is part of those galaxies too. But we recently introduced this matrix-like format. So initially we started with just Maitreya Attack, but we make the format generic to express any matrix-like dataset. So for example, yes, recently we got this contribution called Amit Tactic, which is a misinformation model. So it's basically about fake news and stuff like that. You can basically attach it to MISP events. So that's a different use case of MISP. Again, it's a way to use MISP for specific things like describing misinformation, sources, and so on. Another thing that we had, for example, we had this techniques of attacks against Office 365. As you might know it, Office 365 is a regular target, but sometimes you have to describe such kind of attacks. John Lambert from Microsoft did a very good work on that, so it was in an Excel sheet, but on the other end, you want to use it on a day-to-day basis. So we basically translated that one into MISP matrix-like format, so like that people can reuse it directly. Attack for fraud is one for the financial sectors, is the one about the fraud techniques that are used, and with all the steps there. And we had one especially for the election, which is coming from a work group at the European Union, which is basically describing what kind of fraud that you can see during the elections. Again, those are part of the MISP project. When you install MISP, you can enable those. If you don't care about elections, you don't put it. But if you are caring about election security and so on, then you can add your own there. So if you have other models that you are aware of, if you have no time to do it, just create an issue on one of the GitHub repositories, especially the GitHub repository for the galaxies, and we can work together on that one. So just to conclude this, so it was a very busy year. Obviously, the grant that we got from the European Commission, in addition to our budget that we use on OCCIRT, was really a very interesting bootstrap. But we have plenty of other means of funding or in continuing our work. For example, we are currently working on two other projects. One is called Vario Project, which is a project for open data and IoT security. Another one is Enforce, which is a project that we have running right now for law enforcement and information sharing. So we basically bring the use case that we will see in Variot and Enforce into MISP. For example, for Vario, a lot of work will be done to the feeds. So I think Andras will talk about it, about the rework of the feeds and so on. That's basically something that is becoming important for us. Another thing that we want to do is, nowadays we are close to 60 repository, Git repository on the MISP project, one on GitHub. We have a lot of users that are basically using MISP, but as it's growing, we have to structure a bit the project for various, to have subgroup and so on specific topics. So one of the first steps that we did was a MISP standard one, which is basically a subgroup within the MISP project to handle the standard. But at some point, we might want to extend this into more formalized organization and so on. So we are in discussion with various organizations on that. It's still an ongoing project. But the thing is, we really want to ease the collateral contributions so that like that people can jump in a specific subgroup to basically contribute some, like, for example, a galaxy with thread actors would be, for example, a specific subgroup and so on. So that's basically it for the introduction of what happened this past year. Just a quick note of the many contributors we get on the GitHub repositories of MISP project. So we do some statistics about that. So if you don't see your face there, either you didn't contribute or you are one of those that misconfigure the Git configurations, which happens because GitHub is not accounting the user that have not an email attached to that one. So that's why we are more than 370 contributors, which have basically a GitHub account. So you have a bit more than that. And that's only the contributor on the core aspect, taxonomies, Galaxy, core software, and so on. So if you want to contribute, feel free, at least to get your face there or your icons. So that's basically it for the introductions. Do you have any questions, idea, or feedback before we go for the next one? So now we will have an introduction from someone at the University of Luxembourg that is working with us on the usability aspect of MISP. There are some work there, obviously. And he's doing a survey currently to see what are the aspects in MISP that need to be improved, and he will show you what he's doing. Yeah.